is one market Citi has been in, left, and recently come back to is Saudi Arabia. And as you probably know, recent events in the kingdom, including the arrest of Prince Alwaleed bin Talal on the weekend, who happens to be one of Citigroup's largest shareholders and chief advocates, have cast some doubt on your company's plans. What can you tell us about Saudi Arabia?
Well, I should be turning it back with you being in the news business, but I would say it's been tough to really discern, because while we have some headlines, we don't have much below that. We've got a number of people being held under this broad title of corruption, and we actually don't know what the specified charges or accusations are below that. From Prince Alwaleed's perspective, longtime shareholder, and while you describe him as one of our largest shareholders, he, as an individual, is amongst the largest individuals, but from an institutional perspective,
yes,
is significantly smaller.
And certainly smaller than what he used to
and
be.
Most. But what I would say in our interaction, and we've known Prince Alwaleed for 25 years, is he's been a very consistent, loyal supporter of our company. He's been with us in good times and bad times, and hopefully back to good times. And obviously we're watching. In terms of what we see going back into Saudi, I think you've got to be encouraged by what's been laid out in terms of the Vision 2030. Some of the
economic transformation.
I think it's a societal transformation.
That's true.
When we look at what's going on. So we went back into Saudi Arabia, and when we went back, we said, we're glad, we're proud to be back, but just so you know, the person running our franchise for the region for Saudi Arabia is a woman. They welcomed it. And so we look at some of the progressive things that are happening there. We're encouraged by it.